Today we are going to discuss the laparoscopic appendectomy. Although the laparoscopic appendectomy can be performed in any type of appendicitis, but there are some indications which we should keep in mind that female of reproductive age group, they are the best candidate for the laparoscopic appendectomy. Reason behind that, there are a lot of pathology which can be simulate the lower abdomen pain, and that can be considered as a differential diagnosis of acute appendicitis, just like the oophoritis, PID, salpingitis, simple menstrual cramp also sometimes can mimic the sign and symptom of acute appendicitis. Premenopausal age group patients are also a good candidate for laparoscopic appendectomy, because in this age group, generally there may be psychosomatic reason of lower abdominal pain. And if you perform laparoscopy, you can identify, you can get a lot of unknown pathology. And in those situations, added advantage of improved diagnosis is there. Suspected appendicitis in the male patient, if you have, then also laparoscopy is a good procedure. Then working status, the patient who has the very busy life schedule and who want to get the rapid recovery, for them also laparoscopic procedure can be considered as the method of choice. Obese patient, cirrhosis of liver, sickle cell disease and immunocompromised patient, these all are the good candidate for the laparoscopic appendectomy. There are few contraindications also, like complicated appendicitis. If there is perforation, lump formation and the mass, in those situations laparoscopic appendectomy is little difficult to perform. Although these contraindications are not the absolute contraindications, they are relative contraindications, but then also it is difficult to perform, especially in the hand of beginners. COPD and cardiac disease, if the patient has severe chronic obstructive pulmonary disease or the cardiac disease, in those situations laparoscopic appendectomy is difficult to perform. In cases of generalized peritonitis, suppose there is a ruptured appendix, perforated appendix, and there is now generalized peritonitis, in those situations laparoscopic appendectomy should be avoided. Open surgery would be better option. Previous extensive lower abdominal surgery, in those cases also there will be difficult access. Suppose the patient has 3-4 times cesarean section, and the classical cesarean section, suppose 2-3 times laparotomy, then there may be extensive adhesion into the pelvic organ. And in those situations, laparoscopy should be considered not very safe, especially in the hand of beginners, and you should perform it very carefully. Hypercoagulable states like polycythemia vera and all, in this situation, there is increased risk of DVT. So for like polycythemia vera, first this condition should be treated, and later you can start performing diagnostic laparoscopy, and then together appendectomy can be performed. Stump appendicitis is one of the specific contraindication. Stump appendicitis is a complication of laparoscopic assisted appendectomy. Sometimes what happens that if you have performed the previous laparoscopic appendectomy, and if your stump was big, like 1 centimeter, then that can create again a recurrent appendicitis. Sometimes this was a complication of the laparoscopic assisted appendectomy. In old time, many of the surgeons, they were using laparoscopy assisted appendectomy, like they were putting the port in the right iliac fossa, and then they were extracting the appendix out, because the knotting technique was not good, and then they were tying the knot outside the abdomen. In those situations, you cannot mobilize the cecum very nicely, and there was increased risk of this stump appendicitis. Advanced stage of pregnancy, laparoscopic appendectomy is a method of choice up to 20 weeks of the pregnancy, but after in advanced stage like 30 or 35 weeks, there is increased risk of the rupture uterus, and access also will be difficult, because the uterus is very thin and accidental electrosurgical injury can lead to the ruptured uterus. So this is also one of the contraindication. Lymphangioma of mesentery and chronic inflammatory diseases like the ulcerative colitis or Crohn's disease should also not be considered as a good candidate for the laparoscopic appendectomy. This is the surgical anatomy here. We have this is the appendix, here is the cecum, this is the ascending colon, this is transverse colon, this is descending and sigmoid colon, this is the cecum, here is the appendicular artery, this is the ileocolic artery, and this is appendix. So this is the normal anatomy, but variations are a lot. Like sometimes appendix is very deep up to the pelvis, sometimes it may be very high just the below the subcostal, and sometimes rarely it may be on the left side of the body. Generally it should be on the right, but rarely it may be left. So in those situations the surgeon should be aware with all these abnormal anatomy. Sometimes it will be subserous and retrocecal. In those situations the surgery will also be integrate. It should be taken from here and then you can tie the extracorporeal knot for the continuous structure at this place, and then you can go towards the tip of the appendix. Position of the surgical team. The patient should be put supine and little head down, and then you will do the access. Access should be performed the same way which we have discussed in the access technique chapter, and the surgeon stand to the left to the patient, slightly near the left shoulder, and camera person should be right and behind the surgeon. This is the position of the camera person, just behind and right to the surgeon. One more assistant may be, and the scrub nurse should be left to the surgeon for giving the instrument. In cases of female, you can put the patient in the lithotomy position. So you have the advantage that suppose you want to do uterine manipulation just to see some unknown pathology like endometriosis. Most common place of endometriosis is uterosacral ligament and in the cul-de-sac. In those situations, if your patient is in the lithotomy position, one of your assistants can help you to get the manipulation of the uterus. So this way different type of position and different type of posture can be used, but in the female lithotomy is better. This is the port position. According to base wall diamond concept, your both the working instruments should be in such a way that it should make a 60 degree manipulation angle. The telescope should be in the center, and there should be azimuth angle 30 degree in between the telescope and instrument. To get this, you should have at least 7.5 centimeter away from the telescope, and this way you can perform the appendectomy. Now it is important to remember that when you are putting the port, optical port should be introduced first, and then you should decide the secondary port. Optical port generally is 30 degree telescope we are using, and you can use 10 mm. And other two port you can use 5 mm. But remember that if you don't have 5 mm one extra telescope, then you have to use two 10 mm port. If you have one 5 mm extra telescope, in those situations you can use this 5 mm extra telescope just to have the vision at the end when you are trying to take the appendix out. In those situations you can introduce this 5 mm telescope at this point, and you can take the appendix out through the 10 mm umbilical port. So this way port position and number of port has to be decided. Here the surgeon will be towards the left side, and the camera person hand will be from behind the arm and the body of the surgeon in such a way that there should be the manipulation angle of 60 degrees. So this is the port position generally. There are many alternative port position. This is one of the alternative port position in which there is that is the inferior crease of the umbilicus, and then the laparoscope will be below the bikini line. Bikini line is the line joining both the anterior superior iliac spine, and you can put it in between the pubic tubercle and anterior superior iliac spine, and this way you have the flexibility that cosmetically better outcome. Your patient will not have any scar visible, and this is the advantage. After doing the access through that 10 mm port, you can transfer the telescope again to this 5 mm telescope here, and you can perform the procedure by these two ports. These two ports will be help you to perform the procedure, and at the end again you can take the telescope out with this 10 mm telescopic port. So this is one of the alternative port position of the laparoscopic appendectomy. Some surgeons, they put one suprapubic port, and that will again have the cosmetic value. One is the inferior crease of the umbilicus, another is in the left iliac fossa, and third is suprapubic. And this way you can perform the procedure, and here this way you have the 60 degree manipulation angle. When you are putting suprapubic port, you should must take care that you should not damage the bladder, and you should not damage, sometime there is cremastic artery, and those cremastic vessels also sometimes they bleed. So this you have to keep in mind, and you should be careful while introducing your trocar to the suprapubic region. Here sometime alternatively your one port may be just over the right hypochondrium, and that will help you to get some mobilization, especially in the cases of retrocecal appendix. First step of the surgery is that you should hold the appendix, lift the tip of the appendix up, and then try to expose the entire appendix from the tip to the base. For that you might use the two atraumatic grasper, and then you can walk over to the appendix in order to get the complete exposure up to the base of the appendix. So here we can see these are two atraumatic grasper, and sometimes you might need to push the cecum down. And this way you can retract the cecum and you can expose the complete appendix. Now once it is exposed, then you should make a window. There are many ways of doing appendicectomy, like with the extracorporeal knot, with the stapler, with the help of the simple clip, or with the help of bipolar. And I will discuss all the way of doing the appendicectomy in front of you. So here it is the extracorporeal knot for the continuous structure which will be used. So first you should try to open a window into the major appendix, and then you can just have it, and slowly you can make that window in such a way that it should have the facility to introduce the knot there. And this way knot has been introduced. Once the knot is in, after that you can just tie the extracorporeal knot for the continuous structure. For that you will pass the knot, and this is the knot pusher. And you can tie first the major appendix. Once the major appendix is tightened, after that you can tie the same way the extracorporeal knot over the appendix. So this is the knot, here is the major appendix, and you can tie one knot here, and then you can cut it. And after that you should tie the two other knots over the appendix. After major appendix you can take and you can tie the two knots over the appendix. This is the first knot, go like this, you can have the extracorporeal knot, catch it here, and then take it out. When you are pulling the knot out, you should support it from behind with one of the instrument, so that there should not be any shearing effect over that. And then you will take the knot pusher, and the knot will be tying it on the base of the appendix. It is important, if you want to prevent the later stump appendicitis, then the first knot should must be at the base of the appendix, near the junction of the cecum with the appendix. And then you can cut it. Again you can have the second knot. Distance between first and second should be at least 5 mm, 3 to 5 mm, so that there should not be any big chunk of the fecal matter just accumulated in between. And then you can tie the third one. Distance between the second and third should be at least 1 cm. And then you can coagulate, and after that you can just have the sutures, and with the sutures you can cut. So this way laparoscopic appendicectomy can be performed easily in the cases of the this is the major appendix, now you can cut. So this is the way of using the extracorporeal knot for appendicectomy. Now we will discuss you how to perform appendicectomy with the help of simple bipolar. Here in this patient there was simple appendix. It is a little tortuous but doesn't have much difficulty, and you can walk over to the appendix to get the tip of the appendix completely visible. After that you can bring one Maryland, open the jaw of the Maryland in the line of the major appendix, and a window has been created. Once you have the nice window here, then you can bring the bipolar, and successive desiccation and cutting is required. Intermittent activation of the bipolar is the paramount to prevent any much collateral damage. And this way intermittent activation will help you to prevent any collateral damage, and then you can cut it. Here again you have to go up to the base of the appendix. Remember, when you are going at the level of the base, you should give impulses of the current. You should not press the paddle for more than 3 seconds in one go, otherwise cecum may get the injury. So this way, when you are going near the base of the appendix, you have to use the current. Again you can cut it, and in the way so that there should be the minimum tissue injury. If the bleeding is like that, again you can bring the bipolar and just you can give one or two impulses. Those type of bleeding will automatically stop. Bleeding will stop. After that you can bring the extracorporeal.